Not yet.
Fernie is dreaming about a beautiful woman. They are sitting in a tavern and he wants to seduce her. But he is so tense and the woman is getting bored. He needs something to steady his nerves. A drink would do wonders. He takes hold of the bottle, drinks from it greedily, and rouses.
Ah, I needed that drink. How did you know to give me that? You certainly did. What a strange reverie I had. I hope my friends fared better.
The man seems to be sound asleep. Namda is having a horrible nightmare. He is in a dark cave, trying to run away from a giant troll, but he falls and twists his ankle. The fuming troll is getting closer and closer, but the terrified Namda just can't run fast enough. If only he could heal his wound. Namda fumbles the potion in his sleep, drinks it, and wakes up.
Lord, what a nightmare that was! You gave me that potion, didn't you? Oh, a kind thing to do. I hope you'll be able to wake my friends, because no shouting or shaking will help.
Nightwinkle is fast asleep. Nightwinkle is dreaming about an alchemy contest she desperately wants to win. Panic sets in as she realizes she is lacking a critical ingredient for her potion. Of all things, how could she forget a big red apple? She grabs the apple, mutters something, smiles, and awakens.
Awake at last! Oh, I would have gone mad for sure. Great! Though I'm a bit wary of going to sleep again. What a stupid dream I was having. If it really had to last that long, why couldn't I dream about the unicorn again? Goodbye, my friend. The three of us awake at last. Oh, that dream. I'll never have another red apple again.
It wasn't that bad. I killed this enormous troll with my bare hands.
That's nothing. I dreamt that the most beautiful woman you ever saw came onto me.
Yes. Never mind, eh? What do you say we reward our friend here?
I know. You can have that gem we found up in the hills.
Yes, I still have that. Here, take it with our blessings.
Thank you so much, Slayer. We'll head to Broken Valley now and hope the rest of the journey is a bit less eventful.
Those who slept, you have woken.
Shiny.
Such heroism. Wake me when we reach the Maxos Temple, would you?
I shall hang here, the lamenting bell. No one, Slayer, beats a demon out of hell.
Impressive, Dragon Knight. Impressive. But only the first demonic foe in a line of many.
Not yet.
I've been poisoned!
I can't. Pitiable louse.
Is killing me.
Not yet.
Rest here for a bit, and in the meantime, have a look at what I sell. Take your time. I'm sure you'll find something to your liking.
I've got an arrow sharp as a demon's tooth aimed at your neck, buddy. You better be in a mood to tell me what you want. I haven't had no wife since the day she wouldn't quit nagging.
My fingers are starting to slip, funny pants.
No one enters without giving a password. Damn, you know it. I love shooting people through the neck.
Oh, we've never seen you here before. Say, are you a romantic person by any chance?
Not what I had in mind, but close enough.
The thing is, we want to leave this camp. We've had enough of this life.
It was all fun and games in the beginning, but now me Sybil's pregnant and we don't want our child to grow up in this environment.
Thanks for pointing that out, but leaving is not as easy as that.
Ragnar is suspicious of us, thinks we'll betray the location of this camp, so he ordered Christopher the Porter not to let us pass. But we must. The things they do here. The New Order may think we are mere bandits, but in reality, we serve a vile necromancer. We saw him working once. The screams. The horror.
Now, we'll give you our weapons. We don't need them anymore once our bandit days are over.
But Christopher never leaves his post. It's ridiculous. Please find a way for us to leave, yes? We just want a quiet life.
So it was all that. Please, please, don't kill me.
Oh, I hate it when they do that. Just slice them right away.
I did that.
Come over here. Got a task for you.
Oh, spunky one, aren't you? I'll use my